And a good Thursday to you. It has been super active since late yesterday. Multiple rounds of storms. The first one producing flooding here near and south of the Pike as we had training thunderstorms developing over the same areas repeatedly between 6 and 9 p.m. And look at some of these rainfall estimates from Doppler radar. Over 2.5 inches of rain in some of these communities. Boston Logan officially coming in with just over 2 inches of rain, close to it in Norwood. But that was just round one. Thereafter, we had more thunderstorms, and these produced wind damage coming out of Connecticut into Rhode Island and here in southeastern Massachusetts. Many reports of trees and wires down. A lot to clean up today with this cluster of storms that did prompt a tornado warning when it came into Massachusetts out of Rhode Island just around 11:30 or so last night. You can see, though, that cluster moved offshore and this whole storm system is continuing to shift out. So improvements coming rapidly this morning as the skies clear. Temperatures jumping out of the 60s through the 70s and into the low 80s this afternoon. Notice how our wind is shifting around to the west. That is bringing in the drier air. So we do warm into the low 80s, even all the way to the coastline today with upper 70s on Cape Cod. But as that westerly wind continues to blow in, it brings in the drier air. So our dew points drop from the 60s down into the 50s this afternoon. It is definitely going to be feeling more comfortable in the wake of this front. High pressure settling in, so we're going to clear things out this afternoon, and we're going to keep the skies mainly clear into tonight. It is going to be a much more comfortable night for sleeping without the AC. You can give it a break, open up the windows. We're down low to mid 50s tonight, and tomorrow looks fantastic for your Friday. Pick of the week, sunshine, super low humidity, and look at these temperatures in the 70s. Just a delightful way to end the work week. Now that dry air is with us into Saturday, and then here comes the humidity once again on Sunday. So you're going to feel the mugginess creep back in. I think we're looking at mainly dry weather on Saturday here, but on Sunday, some showers and thunderstorms. The focus for those on Saturday off to our north and west out across New York State and up near the Canadian border. That front then starts getting closer to us Saturday night. So by Sunday morning, we're breaking out into some showers and thunderstorms, and with this front moving very slowly across our area during the day on Sunday, scattered showers and thunderstorms will be around into the evening before this front kicks out on Sunday night. And look at that, early next week, of course, it's headed toward the 4th of July. The weather looks great. Dry weather through Wednesday with sunshine and temperatures not far from 80.